Hey, how's it going? Ben here with a March update for my stock photography thing we're doing. Sorry for the delay again. I'm probably going to be like the 5th of April before I get this video uploaded. That's becoming like kind of a habit. I was trying normally I aim for the 1st, but with work and everything going on at the minute, it's running a little bit late. As you probably saw in the opening credits, I'm packing my bags again and leaving. I found work back on the mainland, so yeah, I'm going to be moving back over to the mainland, leaving the island. So I've just been packing my bags and saying goodbye to my lovely condo. What a shame that is. Yeah, I've got to leave this. I've got to leave all this. You know what they say. You finally get the pool and the sea view, and then they snatch it all away from you. I am a little bit sad to be leaving. I've started to feel a little bit comfortable here. There's still a lot I wanted to do. There's still a lot of places I want to go on the island. I had so many plans, so many video plans, photography plans, and I'm leaving in 2 days. So they're all being pretty cut short. I only found out about the job recently, and my contract is up for renewal now, so it seems like the only time I can leave, really, without extending the contract. And if everything goes to plan, I'll be starting work at the school in next month, so yeah, a little bit fast. I'm hoping everything works out for the better. I'll be making more money, which will be a lot more comfortable. I've not really been making enough money to get by online. Well, I've been kind of breaking even, but I thought I'd be making more, so that kind of was the reason why I started to look for work in schools again. But anyway, that's not really why we're here today. Maybe I should make a separate video explaining the reasons why I'm going back into work in this school after quitting not that long ago. But I need to make this video, and this is the March update for my stock progress, and the whiteboard that regular viewers look forward to, I'm afraid, is already over on the mainland. It's packed and being shipped over there, so I'm going to have to maybe just drop an image, drop a few numbers onto the screen in post. So yeah, the total today was $1.32, so our total for last month, $1.32. Over a dollar, got to be happy with that. And the big news this month would be that we've had a download not on Shutterstock, so that's the first time that's happened. We had a download on Adobe Stock, and we had one download on Adobe and two downloads on Shutterstock and zero on Alamy yet. Alamy been taking a little bit longer to get the images on there. They are approved now, so hopefully next month maybe we'll start seeing some results. But yeah, so I got the one download on Adobe Stock, made me 69 cents, and the two downloads on Shutterstock made me 63 cent. Is that right? Let me just check my numbers. Yeah, that was my maths there. But yeah, so the one download on Adobe 69, two on Shutterstock 63. So yeah, the download pay for Adobe is pretty good. I still have some problems with Adobe, actually. So the images I was uploading this month were the images from Media City. So we've spoken about these images quite a lot on the channel because they're my best performers on Shutterstock, and I was pretty keen to get them uploaded onto Adobe and Alamy. None of them were downloaded this month, actually, and they were all accepted on Alamy, so they've all passed the review on Alamy. But on Adobe, most of them have been rejected, and this has been a problem that keeps happening. So the first set I noticed this with was with a set of photos from Wales, mostly accepted on Shutterstock, not tried on Alamy yet. But a lot of them were rejected from Adobe Stock, and once again, images that were largely accepted on Shutterstock, completely, the whole set was accepted. I uploaded the same set to Alamy and Adobe this month. All of them were accepted on Alamy, and on Adobe, a large amount. I don't actually know how many, but I just keep getting the email saying image rejected, image rejected. So yeah, I'm having pretty bad time of it on Adobe. I'm happy for the download this month, and definitely happy for the fee that I've made. So that's one image made 69 cents. That's massive compared to the regular rate on Shutterstock. If this is the regular rate on Adobe, which I have reason to believe it is, One of my images did make quite a lot on Shutterstock last month, so I got 53 cents for one image, but the other image, and I think it was the same image that got downloaded twice, which, strangely enough. So, but yeah, for one sale I got 52 cents, and one I got 10 cents, so yeah, Shutterstock for you, keeping us all guessing. But yeah, so, and one image on Adobe, 69 cents, pretty decent. But yeah, I'm really a little bit upset, well, not upset, but a little bit confused by Adobe. They keep rejecting a lot of the images that get accepted onto other websites, and I'm struggling to figure out why. If there are any Adobe stock experts, anyone who's been there on the site for a while and who has some information or who knows that there's something a little bit different about the upload to Adobe, please let me know in the comments below, because I'm really struggling. This is a repeated problem. I really don't know why. The same images that get accepted to Shutterstock and Alamy are getting rejected from Adobe. I don't understand that. And they don't really tell you that much as well on the rejections from Adobe. If you get images rejected from Shutterstock, normally they'll tell you pretty specifically what's wrong. You know, if there's a copyright issue, if there's a logo, if there's a person in the picture, if there's too much noise, they'll give you quite a detailed report on Shutterstock. But on Adobe, they all just seem to say technical issues, so I don't even know what the problem is. Hopefully, maybe if we look at some of the images, maybe someone can tell me. If you're you know, a regular user of Adobe Stock, I would really appreciate your help on this one. All right, maybe we should jump on the computer and have a look at what's been happening on Shutterstock and Adobe. So without further ado, let's go. Let's start on Shutterstock. So our total unpaid earnings now are up to 18 cents and no, sorry, that's $18.01. Yeah, 18 cents. I'm lowballing even myself. Didn't think that was possible. Like I said, two downloads on Adobe this month or last month now, because it's April already, and they were both this image. And this is a image of a lighthouse in New Brighton, a holiday destination in Northern England, not too far from Liverpool, in case you were wondering. And yeah, I took these images ages ago. I think I spoke about this image before because, yeah, we had this image downloaded once last month and twice this month. So let's see, I wonder how many total downloads this image has had. Yeah, three downloads all recently. So two this month and one last month for this image of a lighthouse. I wonder what's happened. Maybe there's been a news story about a lighthouse in New Brighton. I'm not sure. That'd be interesting to find out, wouldn't it? I need to start doing more of my homework. But yeah, not a bad image. Pretty simple. There's two boats in the far distance. Very simple lighthouse image. And two downloads. So the first download got 10 cents. The one in London downloaded for 10 cents. And one in Germany got 53 cents. That's interesting. That makes me think it might not be a news story. Maybe it's just random. If they were all in England, which two of them are, then maybe there was a news story in the UK about lighthouses, but who knows? Yeah, not too much to say about Shutterstock. I've not uploaded anything to Shutterstock once again. Some people say that that's an issue. Some people say that you should be uploading consistently. I don't tend to do that. I tend to make a batch of images, edit them all like a big group from my collection, because I've got so many raw images, or so many that I'd edited when I was younger that are pretty bad. So I'm just going back to the raw files and slowly getting through, and I like to make a group of them and upload them all at once. So I'm not sure if that's actually worse. I've seen some people on YouTube say that you should be uploading a few images a day. So yeah, let me know what you do as well. I know I've already asked for comments about Adobe, but yeah, anyone who knows about if there's an algorithm to Shutterstock, anyone who knows that if you should be uploading monthly or weekly, or how do you upload? That'd be interesting for me to know. And if we jump over to Adobe, here we have the exciting news, our first download on Adobe Stock. So we've got $1.69. Excellent. First download is pretty exciting, I guess. Let's see if we can get some information. I'm not as familiar with this website, I'm fairly new on here. But yeah, this image was downloaded. It's a image of a swan in the Manchester Ship Canal. not a particularly good image either, actually, quite blown out and not too good. I guess the colours are interesting. Maybe someone just needed a picture of a swan. Maybe it's a background, who knows. But yeah, and if we go to my uploaded files, this is what I wanted to spend more time talking about. So yeah, I've still got some that I've not filled out the information yet. I tend to take a long time to get around to that. But yeah, not accepted. And I think, yeah, there's hundreds. I don't understand why. It's basically all of my images from Media City that do really well on Adobe, that do really well on Shutterstock. They've recently all been accepted on, yes, it's starting here, all of these have been rejected. They've all just been accepted on Alamy. Most of them were accepted on Shutterstock and Sellwell, and they've all been rejected or not accepted from Adobe Stock. And so it's telling me intellectual property refusal. So during our review, we found that it contains elements that appear to be protected by intellectual property, so we can't be accepted to our collection. Description, title, or keywords. Elements protected by IP may appear in the image. Okay, so this may be to do with my titling of the images, actually. Maybe I'm not allowed to say Media City. Maybe it's protected, but I'm pretty sure my images on Shutterstock were called Media City, but maybe I have to change that. Maybe I need to change the name. Maybe it's just a problem with the title, so I guess I'll try again this month. Yeah, a bit of a step back in the wrong direction, I guess. Maybe an easy mistake. I'll try again and have a look. Okay. I seem to be getting a little bit more information now as well. I swear at first time it was just technical issue they were telling me, so that's better that I'm getting a little bit more data. Let me have a look at some of these images. So technical, now this is what it says, technical issues. Learn more about these reasons. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I understand that not all of them are going to get accepted. But yeah, a lot of these images have also been accepted on Shutterstock. A lot of these are just landscapes. And it says technical issues. And I know maybe there's some of them I would always like accept that my images aren't the best. I don't have the best technicals or the best sort of foundations in photography when it comes to like, especially like the megapixel side of things, you know, especially when it comes to like focus and white balance and getting everything correct. I don't really tend to spend much time on that. I quite like dramatic, overly colorful or images. So yeah, I'm not like the most technical, robotic photographer, but for so many of these, and they were just images of landscapes that normally I have no issues with on the other platforms. But yeah, I have a real high amount of images getting rejected from Adobe, and it's a little bit confusing to me. Like I say, I understand with a lot of these, some of them are quite blurry, a little bit kind of artsy. A little bit artsy kind of composition where I've tried to blur everything out and just have a small amount of the image in focus. I understand with those types of images. But a lot of these are just kind of landscape photos or cityscapes from a distance, and especially images like this, I don't understand why they're not being accepted. And when it says technical issues like this, you really don't get that much information. It just says, unfortunately, during our review, we found that it contains one or more technical issues. So I don't have anything specifically to go back and work with. And again, all of these images from the Lake District, all of these images are accepted on Shutterstock, well, bar a couple. And a lot of them are really strong images, like this one, for example. And I don't understand why they're not being accepted. Okay, so it's just saying similar images on that one. Technical issues, similar image. Yeah, I don't understand. Like, this is a good performer for me on some of the websites, and it's just saying similar image. Yeah, it's a set of landscape photographs from a similar area. So yeah, a little bit confused, but maybe I'm doing something wrong. So I'd like to repeat that SOS call for an Adobe Stock expert to get involved in the comment sections and give me some advice, please. Okay, yeah. So that's all I have for you today. I'm not going to show you my Alamy profile because I don't really have anything to show. The images I have uploaded to Alamy have been accepted, which is cool. But yeah, no downloads yet. I've not finished filling in all the metadata on those images as well. quite interesting. I mean, I guess the images get accepted, then you have the metadata, which I guess is better because it saves a little bit of time on some of the images. I quite like that, actually. I'm growing to like Alamy a little bit. Maybe if I start getting some downloads, I'll like it even more. But yeah, not a bad month, I guess, overall. I didn't do a terrible amount. I got a lot of images rejected off Adobe, so yeah, please let me know if you know. If you have some information or if you're a bit of an Adobe stock wizard, I'd love to hear from you. Yeah, free downloads, not the best, not the worst. Got a decent amount for two of the images. If you enjoyed this video, please like. If you are a stock photographer and you want to follow my progress, then subscribe. That'd be cool. And yeah, I mean, thank you for watching. As always, I greatly appreciate it. I better get back to packing my bags. Next video, I'll probably be back on the mainland, not on the island. I'll be back over in the mainland. So yeah, my days as an islander are over. Very sad. But yeah, hopefully my days as a stock photographer continue and start to grow and grow profitable. That would be great. All right, yeah, thanks for watching. See you again later. Bye-bye.